Hey, where are you going without closing the tap? Look here, on the tap. So much water is getting wasted. Shut the tap, please.
Oh, sorry, but you drop? How?
Yes, I am a drop. I have to often come to life to talk to children so that I can give them information about water and tell them about the importance of saving water.
Yes, our teacher told us the same thing. I should not have left the tap open.
Yes, Raju. Water is very precious. It is critical in helping us stay alive. And yet, there are places where water is not easily available, even to fulfill basic necessities. Let me show you. This village is situated in Rajasthan. There is sand all around. It is very hot here. Such a place is called a desert, and deserts suffer from severe shortage of water. See, village women around walking carrying pitchers and buckets. Do you know where they are headed? They are going in search of water. They fill water at the close by step well. Do you know what is a step well? It is a kind of well which has stairs going all the way to the bottom. This year, the rainfall was less. Therefore, the step well is also on the verge of drying up. It is very difficult to walk on the sand, Raju. The feet suffer, and one has to suffer hot desert winds too. Even to collect minimum water for sustenance requires a lot of effort. Sometimes government sends water tankers to such places. When this happens, villagers ride their camel carts to reach the train and fill up as much water as possible. In this village, life becomes easier when it rains. Do you know why? Because the villagers practice rainwater harvesting. They collect rainwater on the roofs, which is brought to a tank through pipes. This tank is built by digging in the courtyard and making it pakka. This tank is kept closed with a lid. And the pipes too are covered so that dust and pollutants do not mix in the water. This water is made available to the entire village or tribe through a tap. Water scarcity is faced not just by villages but by cities too. Look here. Pushpa works in your home, right? Do you know water runs in her house only for half hour each morning? Pushpa and her brother fill up and store as much water as possible in different utensils and buckets. This water is then used throughout the day for drinking, cooking, bathing, and everything else. On days this much water is not sufficient, then Pushpa goes over to the community tap in the evening to fill more water. But there, she has to stand in a long queue, and everyone has to wait for their turn to come.
Oh, people have to work so hard to get something as basic as water.
Yes, Raju. And hence, saving water is critical. Now tell me, what all will you do to save water?
First of all, I will make sure I never leave the tap open. If the kitchen tap is leaking, I will ask my parents to get it fixed. I will try that. I use the minimum water while bathing and brushing. I will see to it that no water is wasted.
Well done. And also reuse water. After washing fruits and vegetables with water, you can use it to water plants. The water used for washing clothes can be diverted to the toilets. Encourage your school and neighborhood areas to practice rainwater harvesting. All right? Now tell me, what all did you learn today?
I learned about the value of water. There are many villages in India where people have to travel miles to fill water. At some places, tap water is available only for few hours and hence needs to be filled and stored. People also fill water from community taps and water tankers. All of this is very difficult and hence it is important that we conserve water. Rainwater harvesting is a means to do that. And in daily chores, we should be mindful that we use the least water and ensure that no water is wasted.
Very nice. Better late than never. Okay, I'm off now. Bye.